mistake. Come on, everybody, let's get this day started. Hey, everyone. Good morning, good morning. Welcome, all you new folks, and welcome back, everybody, to Loving It on Keto. Well, you guys, I already made a mistake. I made a Shape Up and Slim Down for February challenge. I made it the new way, and I'm not looking at the calendar. I even put Miss Eileen's calendar that she's graciously sends me about Christmas time every year, and I'm gonna be so sad when she finally retires and I don't get one. But I said it was a protein sparing modified fast day today, and it's not, because we always eat. Today's Wednesday, which would be true, except you guys see this on Thursday, and we try to do our protocols and our challenges on the same day. So everything I thought I was gonna do today, food-wise, is gonna have to change, because today, you guys are seeing this on Thursday, is a regular day of eating, using your macros, making protein a priority. It's exercise day, take a walk, lift some weights, and move your body. Now I put these because I exercise with Alejandra on Mondays and Thursdays now. My Tai Chi has changed from Tuesdays to Sundays, so I'm going to be a little off kilter on my exercising, and I apologize for that. I haven't been doing it. You know, I went to Palm Desert with Felicia for a wonderful girls getaway, and coming back, I'm trying to get back in sync. Now, something I want to say is my protocols are for Harry and I. You do not have to do them. And we are not doctors. We're not medical professionals. We're doing something for us and for our bodies. If you want to do any changes to your diet, you need to consult your physician, especially if you have any underlying medical issues, any diagnosed diseases or autoimmunities, or you're on any medication, because it may be counterindicated for you and your body. We're just sharing what we're doing and asking if anybody wants to go along. But you need to make that decision for you. Now, knowing that you are eating 3 times a week, a very low calorie, a protein sparing, meaning we're sparing the muscles and the protein, and we're not cannibalizing our bodies in order to get enough protein. You're doing the protein sparing modified fast 3 days a week. That's why it's very important for every other day to eat your regular macros, and 1 day a week, refuel, eat a little bit more than you normally would. That's the day Harry and I go out to eat, or we have a date night, or we're going out with friends. We use that so that we are not lowering our metabolism and we're not cannibalizing our body. And Dr. Robert Blackburn, George Blackburn created this protocol back in the 1970s for people that were morbidly obese, that had horrible issues, and he needed to get the weight off of them quickly.
What protocol?
It was the protein sparing modified fast protocol, but they did it every single day. And it was extremely restricted, but it was under doctor's care. That's why we use that protocol sparingly. We use the protein sparing modified fast protocol sparingly and every other day. So I just wanted to share that, because Harry and I, especially myself, I am a long-term dieter. I had a lap band installed in my body in 2005, and in November 2019, I had to have it removed because it slipped. It was literally rubbing, sawing its way through my throat and my stomach. It damaged my body, and I had to have it removed. But in that time, I was on 500 to 800 calories, and I only lost 50 pounds in 14 years, and I had a problem keeping that off. So my body is used to low calories, and I've built my body up to eat more food than what I used to, and lose weight. I lost 56 pounds on keto, on the ketogenic lifestyle. And I have to watch everything because my body holds on to the weight with all its might. It does, because I have done so many things to damage my metabolism. Trying to repair your metabolism is a very hard thing to do, especially at my age, right? I'm going to be 70 in March. So Harry and I are both retired. We love to go out. We love to go to the movies. We love to go to new restaurants in the area. We stay keto. We love to travel in RV. We like to socialize with our family and friends, which involves food. We stay keto. However, we gain weight very easily and lose weight very difficultly. So we're not going to close ourselves in and sequester ourselves inside and not have fun for the rest of our life. That is not going to happen.
No.
I don't know what sugars and real sugar and potatoes and pastries that are made in the sad diet realm even taste like anymore, because I have become so adapted. However, there are hidden ingredients when you go out to restaurants and things, even on the meat products that you get and the oils that they put into salads, etc. So if I gain 5 or 10 pounds going somewhere, doing something, traveling, you know, staying at a beautiful, luxurious resort, getting pampered with a spa and eating more vegetables and eating more salads and such, I gain weight. And I did. So I'm back on track here. Now, there is no magic once you get down to your ideal weight or your specific goal weight. My goal right now, I feel great. I look great. I'm in a medium. I'm in a 12. I don't have to lose any more weight in order to feel good about myself. I want to lose more weight. That's me. However, I have noticed so many ketovore folks, low carb folks out there, that they get to their goal weight and then all of a sudden they start incorporating sad diet foods and they have gained weight and ballooned like you would not believe. Yeah. I'm not going to do that. And they always say, any diet you ever go on, any protocol you ever go on, you know, it needs to become a lifestyle. And then when you need to figure out 5 to 10 pounds. If you gain 5 to 10 pounds, you need to get that off right away.
Yeah.
Right? Some people can go 20. I can't go as much as 20.
No way.
Because my body stalls at a hard stall too quickly, because I've tried to do so many things over the years. So we provide.
Amen on that.
Thank you. I'm preaching to the choir, being me. I'm sorry, but this is my life and Harry's lifestyle that we are sharing with you. We're sharing. We're not telling you, we're not preaching to you and telling you what you should or shouldn't do. We're just sharing our life with you. What works for us may not work for you. What you think or feel is up to you, but it's not going to make a difference what Harry and I feel, because we feel differently, right? That's why there are so many different styles of clothes. Different styles of house, different styles of shoes. Everybody's body is different.
Well,
and so you have to work with your body. You got to learn your body first. Then you got to work
true.
With it. What were you going to say?
Well, I think everybody needs to look at this, what we're doing. Yeah, we're keto, but this is more of a documentary style on people that live keto.
We are keto.
Yeah, and we're keto, so.
Sometimes we go more carnivore.
Yeah.
Sometimes we're more ketovore.
Yeah, this is more of a life study.
It's our life.
That's how I look at it, more as a life study. It's not really a cooking show as much. It is. There's a lot of cooking that
we're
goes
just showing
there.
What we do.
Yeah, but also how we go through the day dealing with it. And that's pretty much what we wanted to do in the very beginning.
Right.
And we've tried to do that, but a lot of people really like the cooking. So Wendy's been trying to do a lot of cooking stuff within it. But that's why we show you guys where we go eat and what we're eating while we're there.
Right.
You know.
Just so you know, I haven't taken any cooking classes other than my 7th and 8th grade home economics class. I am not a chef, have never wanted to take cooking classes, have never wanted to be a chef. I don't want to sit in my kitchen all day long and pre-cook and pre-test and fabricate wonderful creations. I want to make it plain, simple, easy. I retired, oh man, is it 2 years ago now? I've been working since I was 16, full time, 16.
Yeah, me eight.
I had a family and raised a family and incorporated a blended family. I've done all those things and I want something super easy, super delicious and nutritious.
Excuse me.
When we were vegan for 6 years and growing up. So that's why I do a lot of foods on the fly, and I think why I'm so good at thinking in my head on how to do it, because my mom would buy, you know, raw vegetables and meats and make homemade bread, and then she would put food on the counter and say it would be Lori's turn or my turn to cook, and you know, to get the food ready, and it would be up to us on once mom taught us how to make a pot roast, how to make, you know, chicken, how to make, you know, certain meals, to do that so that we learned how to do it that way. So when you are looking for a cooking show that's keto, I tried to start one and I can't do two separate shows
too much.
And just do it because I don't want to go through all the recipe books. I don't want to go through Pinterest. I don't want to do all of those things because I'm not looking for recipes. I'm just looking for good, wholesome, nourishing food that's super easy, super simple. Now, I'll look at recipes. Do I follow them to the T? Never, because I just, there's certain things as I'm looking at the recipes, I want to tweak it here, tweak it there, add a little of this. No, I don't like that. And I'll do that kind of a recipe. But to get excited and have to have a printout recipe in order to cook, no, that's not me. So I just wanted to kind of share some of those things. As we get new people, I kind of have to share these things with everybody. Now, I'll use recipes, or I'll watch somebody cook a recipe, and I'm going, that's great. And then as I'm doing the recipe, I'll go, you know, I just want to change this or change that. Or I'll say, I'm using Jane Doe's recipe for the base of my recipe, but I'm changing here and I'm changing there, and actually I've created a new recipe, right? How many Toll House cookie recipes are there? How many pizza recipes are there, right? Who was the beginning person, the very first person who made pizza? It's like the Earl of Sandwich. Who's the first person who invented a sandwich?
Earl,
yeah, the gambler. He wanted something he could put his meat into with between the bread so he could play cards and eat at the same time because he didn't want to leave the gambling table. That's one of the stories that could be an urban legend. I'm just saying things like that. Pleasant surprise when I'm experimenting in the kitchen and something doesn't turn out the way I wanted it to, but it was delicious, right? So sometimes I have recipes, sometimes I don't, and I measure better for you guys than I would ever measure for myself, because I'm a taster and a blender and a blop and a splash and a shake and a pinch kind of a person, rather than, now you need to use the liquid measuring cup for the liquids, and you need to use the other type for this, and you need to use a scale for the grams and the ounces, and that's not really me, in case you guys haven't noticed. But I try for you guys, I really do. But you have to understand, this is our life. Like Carrie said, this is like not even a documentary, but reality. This is reality video on our ketogenic life. Yes, it is.
Pretty much.
It is. And we share a lot along the way. And you can do, you can go out to restaurants if you want to or not. But we're going to, like I said, we're retired. We're going to be doing a lot of stuff and we'll share that with you guys. And you can come along and enjoy it with us. And we add little, Harry has film industry background and he loves doing things. We like with Sally talk. We're we're saying what we think she's saying to us.
Right.
Because let me tell you, that dog is smart. She knows a lot of stuff.
Well, she's around us.
She's around us 24 hours. That's
and
right.
And we talk to her like she's a person.
Yes.
So she knows a lot of words.
Yes, she
because
does.
Because of that, that's any yes, dog would be that way if you just sit and talk to the dog.
Of course
all the time.
They would. Well,
like
any
they're a
animal.
Person, they,
my horse knew
yeah,
that too.
They just pick up on stuff.
Yeah.
You know? Special movements you do.
Yep, yep.
All kinds
so,
of stuff.
And plus she's Harry's service dog, so she's with him all the time. So anyway, just wanted to share those little
But
things.
I'm not her favorite person.
What do you mean?
Oh, you're her favorite person.
Oh, I don't think
oh,
so.
Oh, yeah.
No?
Oh, yeah.
Because when she doesn't get it from you, she's just like a child and comes over to mom and then gets cuddly cozy with mom.
Until mom says, give her something, David.
Or I say, no, that's all. We're done. That's it. All gone.
Then she gets all glassy-eyed.
Then she gets all pouty-pouty.
This dog gets tears. You ever? She gets big tears.
Oh, when you tell her no.
Oh, yeah. Big
like
alligator
children.
Tears, man. Just
like
a little kid.
Anyway, you guys. So now I have to rethink what we're going to do, but we have places to go and things to do today. I've got to drop off some stuff at my daughter's. Some of her mail still comes to me, even though they're back from Germany now. I've got to go check the P.O. box. I've got to do some running around today, and it is freezing cold outside. I mean, it is cold and raining, and it rained all night long.
Yeah,
we had
yeah.
a little bit of thunder really,
yeah,
really late last night.
She caught it, but I didn't
I
catch
did.
It.
I did. I said, is that thunder or is that like an airplane going over? But I think it was thunder because of the way Sally acted. But got to get some stuff done, and maybe I'll be thinking of what I want to cook when we come back. But one thing I do know is I've noticed that when I eat a lot of vegetables and salads and things, more the doctor...
heavy oxalates, yeah.
Well, yes, that too, you guys. My hands, since I went to Palm Desert and ate all the vegetables and things that I ate and had some peanuts and some, you know, I had some Asian foods with all the...
Did you have any...
What do you mean bad
did
stuff?
Did you have any spinach while you were there, by the way?
No. I had a...
Because that's the worst.
But what... Okay, you said the word bad stuff. I did not go off keto.
No,
so
no.
I
what do you mean by bad stuff? I'm talking about oxalates with
yes.
a lot of oxalates.
Oxalates.
Yes. That's what I'm talking about. That to me is the bad stuff because when I eat too many, I get...
Gout. So, between me eating more vegetables, like when we had at the teppanyaki, that it had bell peppers, it had onions, it had zucchini, it had stuff that had lectins and oxalates in it. The salads that I had, you know, some of the nuts that I had, all of those things over a 5-day period, even though I stayed keto, and then coming home, and then of course they cook with the, if you watch that video, he poured canola oil or soy oil or whatever kind of oils
yeah.
that he
vegetable
used and
oil
stuff.
Something, yeah.
He used the vegetable oils, and then we had a change of weather here. My hands have been killing me. So I've been using the red light therapy. I use Arnica on them, but I know I've got to get the oxalates out. So we're going to be eating a lot more carnivore-ish
yes.
Foods over the next few weeks to help me get past that point because my hands really hurt and I need my hands in order to do stuff. I mean, my hands, I can't even open things right now because my hands hurt. And it's my wrist. It shoots up through here. It shoots up through my little finger. Yes, I've been tested once for an x-ray and everything else for carpal tunnel. I do have some regular arthritis, but not a lot. And so that was 2 years ago when I was tested. I can't remember.
Yeah,
but anyway,
yeah.
I noticed that I get inflammation really, really easily. And I know this is oxalates because I was using cinnamon every day and my yogurt. All the things pile up and you don't realize that the chocolate, the cinnamon, the vegetables, all the things,
the nuts,
seeds that they put on, all add up to all of a sudden oxalate overload, and now I've got to get it out of my system. So that's what we're going to be doing. Cauliflower is great. It's very low in oxalate, so you don't have to worry about that. So anyway,
unfortunately, it's a lot of the a lot of stuff like lettuces and stuff like that.
Well, even in the seasonings. right?
Stay away from, I'm telling you, if you have any kind of aches or pains, stay away from spinach.
Just
oh my God.
Put spinach out of the picture.
Yeah.
Just, it's toxic. Just put it, kale. Before we left, I was eating kale Alfredo with kale in it. So, you know, creeping up, now I got to creep back. So yeah. Anyway, you guys, we've got to get out the door and we'll see you guys in the next segment. We are home and Harry just cut steak and look who showed up to the party.
Yeah, all of a sudden she wakes up.
Hi, honey. How are you?
Doing good, Mama. But what a good sleep.
Was?
What's over here? You got some? Nope. Oh, sorry.
What?
Thought I smelled something.
You, beef? Did you smell steak? Well, here, Daddy cut a whole bunch of steak. Would you like a piece?
Oh, a steak? Can I have a piece of steak?
Yes. Let me get one for you. I know you like steak. Okay, sit down.
Hurry.
Okay, steak.
Oh, steak. My favorite meat.
I'm going to make some eggs. Would you like some eggs, too?
Oh, yeah. Eggs?
Mm-hmm. Steak and eggs?
I love that. Steak and eggs.
Okay, so we're going to put it on your plate, and then you can have some after we have ours, okay?
I got to wait?
Yes. Is that okay?
No.
How about a little cheese right now?
Cheese? I'll take some cheese. Oh, yeah, please, please, please.
Okay.
Cheese is my favorite.
No, everything's your favorite. Here we go. Let me get this open. If I can get my fingers to work, I can't. Dang, nabbit, this is frustrating.
Well, that's why I try to cut those tabs on there.
So yeah, I did it, and I didn't cut tabs for me. So here you go, little one. I'm dropping. Thank goodness the housekeeper is coming tomorrow. Here, there's a piece. Here's a piece.
It's okay, I'll check the floor.
Here's a piece right here. And I got, and there's a piece of tree. I gotta
keep
wash
going.
My hands. I don't know what that is. That's not tea. What's over here?
Those are pieces of mesquite.
Yeah.
Tree. That's little dinky things. I hate them.
That's definitely not what you want to eat.
Right. Okay. So you be good, and I'm gonna cook now. Okay.
I'll go check over here. See what's going on.
No, somebody dumped something on the floor over there. Thank goodness she's mopping the floor tomorrow.
That's right.
That's all I can say.
Yeah.
Okay, I've got potato bread.
Wait a minute. Tomorrow's mopping the floor day? That means I got to roll up all the rugs.
Yes, absolutely.
You don't understand. You hire somebody to come clean your house, right? You got to clean your house before they show up. It's crazy.
You have to put your stuff away. Yes, dear. Yes. Okay, don't get me sidetracked here. I've got bread in. We're having a omelet, and I'm using leftover steak because I cooked 3 ribeye steaks, and I have 1 8-ounce. It was exactly 8 ounces. I measured it last night just to see how much I had, and I'm going to heat my steak, and then I'm going to make an omelet. Use the rest of this Monterey Jack cheese, which isn't a lot. It'll just give.
I cut that up, by the way.
I said Harry cut it, didn't I?
No, I didn't hear you give me no credit.
Oh, I'm giving you credit. So I am giving myself 3 eggs in here.
Oh, let me see it. Let me get down there. There they are.
And I am using this measuring cup. Yes, I know it's not a liquid one, but this is what I'm using.
But it's so pretty.
Because it doesn't matter, because it's not going anywhere except in our stomach. So this is the amount I like.
Well, I think that's pretty important myself.
Yes, it is.
So do I.
Yes, Sally. Thank you, Sally, honey, for chiming in on that one. Because she wants some eggs, too. And so I use more egg whites lately. It's just because I like them. Here, let me put this over here. Let's warm this up. Let's put the eggs away. Put my eggs away. I should have bought more, Harry, at Costco.
All right.
Costco has quail eggs if you guys want any, but ours are in a weird spot. They used to be in the dairy and egg section. They were over in the cheese, the deli cheese and salami section. So I thought that was weird, and I noticed them as we were leaving the area after I found the healthy noodles, which is where they put them as well. The healthy noodles were on the outside aisle of the deli section over by the meat.
Yeah, but you gotta have a really small skillet to do quail eggs.
Okay, Barbie size.
Yes.
Easy bake oven.
It's like the sparrow eggs we had at one time.
We didn't have sparrow eggs, we had finch eggs.
Finch eggs, excuse me.
That was an experiment. You talk about dinky winky, the egg itself was like this size.
It was like the size of your thumbnail.
Yes.
Actually, it was smaller than that.
Okay, come look. I'm just getting some heat into my meat right here. Heat into the meat and pouring the egg solution into it. Yes, I am.
You put any cheese in there?
No. Honey, you don't put cheese. I do not put cheese in. I wait until it's done, put it in the middle, and
well, is that how you?
Yes.
I've only seen you make them about 50 times. I'm not, you know, it's got
50
it
only.
Takes 51 for me to remember things.
Only 50 times?
Yeah.
You've seen me make them hundreds, if not thousands, of times, because omelet's my only favorite thing I like for breakfast, except for poached eggs with hollandaise sauce.
That's why I chose.
I have another.
Because I know she likes them.
So Harry had some pulsa left, so he's got some pulsa that he's gonna have. We've got an 8-ounce cut up steak that was leftovers, the rest of the cheese, which maybe looks like an ounce, so it's going like in the middle. We're having a piece of potato toast that's gonna be buttered with the honey, the Wholesome Yum honey on it. So you guys, I need to get two plates. Let me get this checked here. You know what? I'm gonna use cherry wood smoked salt from Redmond because I love Redmond products.
Oh,
yes,
yeah,
I
man.
Do. And they've got the big bags in. You know, we keep
better
this,
get them while you can.
Yes, 15% off discount down in the description below. I keep the small ones, and then I buy the big ones to refill. Right. This one is 14 ounces versus 4.5. So I've got this to put in here. Always. I've got one of every single flavor. Don't I, Harry?
Yeah, the best thing to do with that salt, to tell you the truth, is if your husband starts to fall asleep, open that up and just kind of wave it under his nose.
It's better than smelling salts.
Oh, he will wake up so quickly. Oh, much better than smelling salts. Yeah. Ooh.
That's funny. I never thought about that. Male smelling salts. They should package it as such.
You talk about barbecue.
So I can see the ad. Here it is. Is your husband falling asleep after every meal? Are you leading a dull and boring life because he's over there snoring? Well, I say just buy some Redmond real smoked salt, open it up, and wave it under his nose gently. And as he wakes up, you can say, time to barbecue, honey. Here's the meat. There's the barbecue. Right? Something like that. I don't know.
Yeah, it worked. It worked for me, but, you know. I'll say, okay, well, wake me when you're done cooking it.
Well, that's because you don't barbecue, but you need to.
I used to do all that stuff.
I know you did, and I don't know what happened. What happened, Harry? I could say
I
what
can
happened.
Tell you what happened. We lived in Washington where it got super cold.
Yes, I was just going to say.
I'd never go outside.
Are you looking at the...
Oh, no. Oh, there's cheese there.
Yes, there is.
Oh,
there's
sorry, Sal. There. I didn't mean to say that. You already gave her some, though, right?
Yes, I did. Mm.
There it goes. Oh, look at that. Oh. Mmm. Oh, so good.
I'm gonna let that, turn that off just for a second. Cover this, and I'm gonna remove it off the heat, or at least partially off the heat. And then I'm gonna watch that, Harry, because this is extremely hot right here.
Oh, is it gonna do tricks or something?
Yeah, it's gonna trick you and burn your arm. Oh, look at the potato bread, how well that, oh, look at this.
Oh, look at this, man.
Look how nice that toasted. Yes, it did. Yep. Oh, yeah. I'm a toast girl. I like the butter and the toast.
Yeah, me too.
Nice.
I'm a toast girl, too.
You're a toast girl?
Yeah.
I'm glad, honey. There you go. How about some, look, honey, you guys. That pours like honey. Look. This is the bestie, and I just found out from a viewer that they make it in more flavors. They make jalapeno, and they make, what other flavor did she say? Anyway, I'm very excited, and this one is bestie, and this is wholesome yum. Yes, indeed it is. Okay. Let's get this over here, and let's get this breakfast started. I gotta get Sally some of this.
Yep. Here, you want a plate?
Yeah, where's her little plate?
Right here.
You can cut that up with her little
meat. Yeah, I'll cut it up.
Okay, good. Okay, I'll make, oh, that one can be mine. I don't care.
No, I don't care. I don't mind a little sweetness with my egg. I got sweetness making it for me, so.
Oh, yeah. Boy, did you get brownie points right then. You know what I forgot to do, though? Let me nuke this real quick. Heat this up.
What is it? Oh, it's my, thingamajig.
Why is it doing that? 30 seconds start there.
It's the operator.
Yes, operator error because my hands aren't working. I'm very excited.
Your hair needs to be combed in the back.
Oh, thank you, dear. It's windy outside. Is that better?
Yep.
I can't believe how long my hair is getting, like very quickly.
Yeah, I won't let her cut it.
You won't let me.
That's right.
You mean you've asked?
I'm the king around here.
You mean you've asked me?
That's me.
And you mean you've asked me nicely if I would please let it grow a little bit longer, right, Harry?
Wendy, I'm on camera. I can't, you know, be real, will you?
Oh, okay. I gotta let him be macho. Okay. What did you say, honey? What do I gotta do?
You gotta let it grow longer.
Okay. Yeah. Nope, 30 more seconds. Anyway, you guys, I've got hamburger bison out, and I had a chicken breast out, so I guess I'm cooking chicken breast and bison. I was gonna have the chicken breast for dinner. Ooh, look at those clouds coming in. Big.
Something's popping.
Yep. I got a new shield of protection. They don't have the style I had. This one's the kind I have in our Vita, but I like it. My old one bit the dust.
Yep, the other one, just the handles coming off, the middle thing that allows steam out, broke off, you know. We've had it a long time.
We have.
I'd say we've had it about 5 years, 5-6 years.
At least, and use it like every
day. And we had two of them, and we wore both of them out.
Okay, you guys, this is what we're having. A steak, a ribeye steak, omelet, pulsa kielbasa, toasted potato bread with Kerrygold butter and wholesome yum allulose honey. Woo! Yes, indeed. So you guys, we're gonna go over here and we're gonna eat now. Now, Sally, Daddy and I gotta eat first. I forgot that we were gifted these beautiful placemats.
Oh yeah.
And I have some in our Vita. And I've got some here for us, so I'm all peacocked out. Got my coffee. I've got my pillow. Now, I want to taste the potato, toasted potato bread with my honey. What about me, Mom? We're gonna eat now, and then you get to have yours, okay? Okay, Harry, gotta eat now. Potato, toasted potato bread is yummy with butter and honey. Oh my gosh. Mm.
I'd like to have some bread and honey too.
After we're done.
Okay.
Tell me what you think about honey on that bread, the potato bread.
Mmm. That was so good.
Bring back memories.
Yeah.
Let me know what your omelet tastes like, dear.
Oh, we got a piece of steak in there.
Oh, I like your shirt.
Hmm?
Let me see your shirt. That's one of the new ones I bought you. Bigfoot means E.T.
Yep.
Absolutely.
Yep. My kind of shirt.
Do you need some La Victoria, dear? I got the La Victoria and the Primal right here. And there's more Redmond Cherry.
We'll just put some of this on, man.
Okay. Well, you guys, we're going to eat now. See you guys in the next segment.
Okay, Sal, you want your breakfast? Sal, you want your breakfast? Huh?
Oh, yeah. Please. I'm so hungry watching you guys eat. Oh.
There you go.
Boy, Papa, you gave her a feast of eggs and beef.
I know, right?
Oh, it tastes so good. I think I like the steak. The eggs are so good.
How do you like the toast and honey?
Oh, it was really good. Was that what that was? It was nice and sweet. It's really good. Oops, I dropped a piece. It's my save. Oh, where is it? I know it's over here. I know. Oh, there it is. I got it.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mama. It was so good.
Well, you're welcome, honey. I'm glad you enjoyed it. I'm glad you liked the honey bread. Do you like potato bread?
Yeah. I love potato bread. Yeah. Hey, Dad, can you give me something else?
Oh, honey, your tummy is so full right now. Don't you feel full?
Aren't you full?
No, I can eat another plate of that. It was so good. I'm looking to see if I dropped anything. I think I dropped something somewhere. No, way over here, maybe.
Okay, honey, I'm going to clean your dish now, okay? You get to go for another long puppy downtime.
Maybe I should make it one more time.
Oh, I see something. I don't know what this is. Got it.
Nope, just dirty carpet.
You sure?
Yep, I gotta vacuum all the carpets so Papa can roll them up so the housekeeper can come and clean the tile floor. Okay, all done. It's all done. Hey everybody, we're gonna close out the video because it is 5:41 and neither one of us are even hungry.
Yeah, I'm not even.
At all. We're thinking maybe a keto chow ice cream. Split it in about an hour or so, but yeah. Harry needs to get to editing. So we're going to close out the video for today. Thank you so much for joining us. Tomorrow is Friday. I'm thinking it's a protein-sparing modified fast day, or PSMF. Baked protein, your priority. Eat and track 20 grams or less of fat, 10 grams or less of carbs, and eat 600 to 700 calories total. Yes, indeed. Ah, the housekeeper's coming. I gotta roll up all my carpets, get them out of the way. Harry's gotta carry them for me and put them in the laundry room so she can mop the floors and all the good stuff. I have to pick up. Harry needs to pick up because he's the guy who like just leaves stuff.
I got too many things to do.
He just leaves the little pile everywhere. Anyway, you guys, we'll see you. Oh no, I forgot to do the whole thing. And Sally came in. Look, say goodnight. Here, come on.
Well, you gotta go like this.
Oh, like, subscribe, ring that little bell, give us a thumbs up. We'll see you right here tomorrow. And Hallie, Sally is saying good night. I know we all hurt you.
You gonna give me something, Mom?
Okay, I'm gonna give you something, Sally. How about some chicken?
Okay, I love chicken.
I know you do. Can you say good night, everybody?
Are you gonna say it? Come on, you can speak.
Good night. There you go. A little bit more. Oh, I know you love your chicken.
I love my chicken.
Mommy's got furry slippers on. There you go. Say good night.
I said it already. Good night. I love you.
I love you too.